This is going to be a little video showing you the Remploy Civil Responder Peeler Coverall. Now, this is the outer garment of what usually, in its official capacity, would be a three-piece system of protection. This is supposed to be for CBRN, which is chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear environments. And people who don't really look into it will be buying these as part of like a prepping thing, thinking that, you know, if a nuclear war happens or something, that they're going to be able to use this particular overall, which I'll show you in a minute, coverall, and it will protect them. And that's not strictly speaking true. So this is specifically because they give the three different layers names. This is the peeler. Now let me read to you what it says about the peeler. Peeler, outer layer, is a rugged one-piece coverall protecting the user from head to ankle, made from high-performance Nomex meta-aramid fibers and materials laminated with PTFE membrane. It offers superior flame retardant, excellent, and liquid / vapour / bioprotection. So, what does that mean? That means that if you are subjected to liquid splashes, it will protect you from that. Some bio threats, so, you know, if there's organisms, you know, floating around, like anthrax perhaps or something, then yes, this would protect you from that. And I've seen some information about Nomex and laminated PTFE membranes that suggest they would also protect you from nuclear particles. So, that's the packaging. And here is the coverall. So it's fire retardant, which is one of the key features after researching these that made me want to try and get one, because I like that idea. You may or may not know about me that I like to get as much kind of functionality, but not goofy functionality like the bathroom buddy. But like good, you know, if something's got more capabilities, great. So this is good for DIY, which is what I've been using it for. I've been using a Black & Decker mouse sander to sand upstairs. So it's a little bit dusty, but I've brushed off most of it. And this is a full length coverall, and it's relatively heavy. I think the seller said something like it was a kilo. And, you know, it's not the easiest thing to hold up, but I'm going to show you its features. It has a hood, and the zip goes quite high up as well. And this hood is intended to go around a respirator, or a gas mask. And I will put a little card somewhere over here, because I have a video on the particular gas mask that goes well with this, and that I was using while sanding, because I forgot I had this, and I was getting absolutely covered in fine particles of dust. So this came in really handy. Now, it zips all the way down the front, as you would expect with most coveralls, and it's double zipped. So once you've zipped it all the way up, if you want to access something from your pocket or a belt, you don't have to unzip the entire thing. You can just use the zip at the bottom to zip it up a little bit, and you can stick your hand in and get in your pockets. Here's one of the good things. Since this is for CBRN environments, here's your zip. You can see that. So you would zip it up, and you've got like the intermediary like flap that's right next to the zip that kind of just goes together, meets. But then you've got this flap that goes over the whole thing, and then you've got the Velcro other part that goes over that. So you end up with like a really sealed front area where the zip is. So if you're doing sanding and things, that's you're not going to get anything covered on your clothing. And especially if you've got a respirator on with the hood up, you can use this with like a normal dust mask. Like one of these, but these, they don't protect your eyes, and they're not that perfect. Like little cracks, bits get through, so I recommend a proper respirator if you can get one. But it's full length. You've got a pocket on the right chest, pocket on the left chest, which this the one on the left has Velcro for where a police marking would be. Then on the left arm, you do have a pocket, and these are all Velcroed all the way across to help stop, you know, getting anything inside the pockets. So you've got two chest pockets, one on that left arm. There isn't a pocket on the right arm. On the back, there's Velcro. What, a piece here, that's where another police flap would be for identification. Here's the inside on the back. There's some information for you. So it can be washed up to 10 times if you want to keep the CBRN capabilities, but as I said, the CBRN is kind of limiting because you're supposed to have three layers. The intermediate layer that goes right under this, which I don't have because that's not really reusable, has like activated charcoal in it and all kinds of stuff for gas protection. This will not protect you from gas. Remember that. The seams inside are taped, and that increases the strength and durability, but it also adds to the protection. But here's the thing, most of these particular garments that you're going to find on eBay, with possibly some exceptions, are new old stock. Or worse than that, some of them are used. Now this was kind of new old stock, marked as new. And even before I used it, some of these taped seams weren't taped. So if you were actually planning on using this as more of a CBRN preppy kind of thing, I would not recommend that you get new old stock, and I would recommend that you check the garment before you use it, or before you need it, and for that kind of environment. Because while this is going to be great for my needs, if this was to be used in a dangerous environment where chemicals and things were, that could be a problem. Maybe not, but it's the point that it's kind of an unknown. So just bear that in mind. There's like a couple of bits here that I've got to cut off, because just the heat of using it and the fact that it's new old stock means that some of the actual tape itself has fully come off of the seam. But for like average kind of purposes, if you want a really good coverall with fire protection, liquid protection, you know, waterproof, then it's a good, I really like it and I recommend it. But just don't overestimate what it's going to do for you. So, got a cargo pocket on the left leg, right there. And a dusty cargo pocket on the right leg. And again, they're all Velcroed all the way across to help stop getting things inside. And on the leg area, at the bottom, you've got the opening for your feet, of course, but then you've also got a zip which has like a flap built into it. So I didn't know how this was going to work until I actually got one, but this is just an open flap, but it's still like a closed environment on the inside. So nothing is completely ripped open or anything. And what you do is you can put that over your boot at the very bottom and then zip this down, so that you end up with a nice tight seam, like a tight closure around your boots. Or in my case, since I was just indoors, I only had socks on, when you zip this all the way down, it kind of stops it from draping down over your feet and you don't end up stepping on stuff, you know, so it kind of keeps everything out of the way. And there's a nice little seam that covers the zip, mostly. So, there you are, there's the Remploy Peeler Coverall. I do recommend these if you're looking for like a fireproof, waterproof, generally useful coverall. Then I think this is an exceptional option if you can get one that's kind of new old stock. Just be aware that it's not guaranteed to be 100% perfect for like a superbly dangerous environment. There you go. It's really nice. You can have a look on Google for the Salisbury Novichok attack, and you will see police with these on And over the top, most of them, you can find that just were wearing these in the mask, but you'll find that a lot of them had the grey Tyvek, Tycam F suits on over the top, just so that they, I guess, didn't have to wash these as much to like give them more life. So, there you go. Just before we go, I will tell you the information for the Britannia intermediate level of the garment, which I do not have. This is the outer garment, but there are Britannia intermediate layers that are on eBay. But here's the thing, they have charcoal in, and they can expire, they have a shelf life. But if you were to use this for a full CBRN environment, you'd have to get it. And this is what it says. Britannia intermediate layer is a hooded full body cover garment worn over the cooler layer, and the cooler layer is just essentially like pajamas. It's made from unique lamination of polyester and adsorptive carbon layers and biomembrane filter with butyl seals at ankle, wrist and face plane to integrate closely with ancillary equipment, and that means like gas masks, boots, things like that. With chemical-proof rear zip access, it represents a major advancement in CBRN protection against vapor and particulate contaminants. Okay, so you would need not only this outer peeler layer, you would need the Britannia as well. So I think you're gonna maybe struggle to get both of those in like superb condition. Make of that what you will. I figured I'd just tell you about that anyway, because some of you are probably checking this video out because of the CBRN protection. That's kind of like what I want to dispel some of the myths that all you need is this one coverall and that's it, because you don't. There's more to it. You've also got over boots that you would need. You need specialized gloves if you were using it for CBRN. So there you go. Hopefully you found this video useful or interesting. Please like, subscribe, and I'll see you on whatever the next video happens to be about. Thank you.